Okay, been kind of hit and miss here. The catalyst for my rage filler had coagulated into like clay inside the tube, and even with massaging, when I put it on, it didn't activate it, so I ended up having to strip all of it out. So I went to Walmart and picked up a new tube of Bondo Catalyst and tried it out, and it worked out just right. So I'm gonna finish getting that all dressed up so it's nice and smooth. And then I will begin prepping to do the epoxy within the whole cockpit, except for the dash, the back of the dash. That, by the way, isn't rust, Dad. It's glue. So then, except for these horizontal ones and the floor pans, will be all done in here. I wanted to show you my AirCat dual action sander. The AirCats are nice. I've got one for my cutting wheels, but they exhaust out the back and they have mufflers in the plastic cases. So it's tons quieter than the, Harbor Freight ones. Of course, this is, $90 and this is $15. And they use a lot less air too, which isn't a huge deal with my compressor, but my Harbor Freight one broke. The pop metal that holds the orbital thing in just shattered. But this one is really soft touch. You can adjust the speed. It's really nice. So I'll be hitting that with that. And then I use the Harbor Freight straight line sander to do the stuff on that big, large flat area. All right, so that's all popped off nicely. While that's been curing, I went ahead and hit it with the where the speaker holes were with the DA, which highlighted a couple of high spots. So I hit those with the little, the little super coarse disc, which takes the welds down really fast. Got it smooth. Scuffed it all up, and then I'm going to go ahead and put a coat of Rage Bondo on that. It's kind of pointless because nobody will ever see it because it'll all be covered with glue and all that kind of stuff, but it was kind of lumpy. So I put tape along the edge of the swedges and the holes, using those as the reference points, and then I'll fill in all this area, and then it should sand out nice. All right, got there. I hit a couple places along that side that look like they might be a little thin. So we're gonna let those cure and then hit them with the DA. All right, it's after 3, so it's time to quit for the day. Those are all nice and smooth. That's all nice and smooth. I put the bond over the fiberglass stuff because the fiberglass stuff doesn't lay out very smooth because that's fiberglass in it. And I started scuffing everything to get ready to shoot epoxy primer. I was trying to figure out, I need to do another phosphoric acid treatment up there because it got some surface rust, flash rusting in the last couple weeks. But really can't do that with the filler because it will ruin it. And so what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to shoot epoxy tomorrow, getting this side finalized, that side finalized, all except for the
very front of the footwell.
And that way I can put the phosphoric acid treatment on that. And, you know, it won't bother the epoxy primer. So that'll be the plan tomorrow. All right, so back at it. As I mentioned yesterday, my plan is to go ahead and finish scuffing the metal in the driver's side cockpit. And then I will mask off the front area because with the brake fluid and all that stuff, we got some surface rust from trying to wash that off. So I'll phosphate that, or phosphoric acid it again. And I think I'm going to start by putting weld through around the, where the footwells go on both sides, and then continue my sanding. All right. The holes here, I noticed that this one was broken at the top. And all spread out, so smoosh it back into place. I'm gonna put a little weld on that to fix the metal, well, before I prime and stuff. And I put my aluminum eighth inch piece behind it, which acts as a heat sink, and then I use the copper on the front, which again acts as the heat sink, although probably not enough to matter. But squeeze everything together to get those two pieces lined up. I forgot to mention, I also, there's a little ding by that hole in the filler, so I touched that up. And then when I was stripping the metal around the footwell hole, where I'm gonna put the weld through primer, I ended up nicking the filler on the side there, so I hit that too. All right, so I got the, let's see if I can get a good angle on that. A couple little tacks on there, and I can grind that off with the 2-inch sanding disc. It'll be just like brand new. Remember I talked about my experiment with the grease? Well, it worked. So I'm going to switch out the these little abrasive wheels, which rock. Even the normally I don't buy consumables from Harbor Freight because they suck, but these work out really well. But caught all the grease, so it didn't go anywhere. I'm going to use the carbide bit to finish trimming out that hole that I just welded up. Now at this point you're probably going, Jim, what repair did you make? So it turned out really nice. Should hold for a long time, so good to go, moving on. Alright, finishing up for the day. I have hit everything with the red Scotch-Brite, where I'm gonna be welding in the floor pans and the lateral braces. I put weld through primer. Everything is wiped down with wax and grease remover. So hopefully tomorrow I'll be motivated to come out and shoot the epoxy. So we have one consistent finish all the way through, except for back in there, which still need to do the phosphorus, but I don't want to do that until everything's protected back in there. Alright, so spent the last few hours getting everything masked off so we can shoot epoxy primer. That's the wiring harness that goes up the driver's footwell cover plate, and it had a lot of surface rust, so I had soaked it in the evapo rust, and so it's ready to shoot. I'm gonna wait till tomorrow and have Derek shoot it in the morning. Okay, just a little update. So I had Derek shoot the primer, so that all of the filler is fully sealed and encased, which means that it's good to go forever. That also sealed the filler down there in the corner along the bottom of the sill that I repaired. And so now I'm going to go ahead and shoot some of the phosphoric acid to clean up the little bit of flash rust that's popped up along that panel where the brake fluid was dripping, and then I'd clean it. So we're getting close to wrapping this baby up. At least the cockpit. Lots more work to do. All right. We are pretty much all done with the interior. Derek just finished epoxying it. Got all that in there. So we're in good shape. I can't do the footwells until I get underneath and get all of the undercoating off, because the footwells sit here and there's that support that goes forward and back, and there's not enough room between that and the footwell for me to get that cleaned out. So I got to get all that cleaned out first. And I'm not putting these lateral braces back in because I've got to, you know, plug weld all the way around this, and that being the way will just make it harder. So I'll do those last.